Okay. We haven't killed the firekeeper, so she should be fine, I suppose.
Welcome home, Ashen. Speak thy.
Can I talk to you now? One.
Before I am seduced by the.
So she wants. Very well. She still wants me to kill her, but we're not going to do that. We're still not going to do that. So, boosting up dexterity, it is then. Spend one, and then we need 10,000 souls extra. So we have consumable souls. I think my character is dancing. How much is this? Let's try this one first. 10,000, perfect.
Welcome.
Perfect. Very well. Then take level up. Put another point into dexterity, putting it at a nice 40. There we go.
Farewell, Ashen Mace.
Yeah, farewell. And I am going to put those ashes where they belong. But first, I'm going to check out Ludlit's inventory, what we can make with that soul.
Aha, so the eyes are plenty.
Okay, never mind. So begin transposition. There it is, Lorien's Greatsword. Ultra Greatsword of Lorien, Prince Lothric's older brother. Cast in smoldering molten steel and stained black. Before Lorien embraced his brother's curse, he was a knight who single-handedly slayed the demon prince. But the victory eternally scorched his sword with flame and probably crippled him as well then. That's why he was crawling on his knees. Flame of Lorien, lunge forward to transform Smolder into flame and follow its strong attack to launch flame across ground. So we've seen him use that. During the boss battle, is there something else? Is there something else? Because usually we have two items we can get for one soul. But this doesn't seem to be the case. Oh, wait. Lothric's Holy Sword. Prince Lothric's Straight Sword, blessed by Emma with potent magic. So Emma was the priestess in the cathedral that died before we had to fight the dancer. Young Lothric was meant to be a champion and was expected to wield this platinum sword. But some things will remain distant dreams forever. Sacred Lothric Light soon stands to imbue Lord Sword with sacred light and use strong attack to release light together with a great trust of the sword. So that's also something we've seen him use, but that's fate required and we don't really have that now, do we? It is the cooler item of the two.
I don't choose that all.
So I'm going to buy that. So let's pop another soul. I think that's 8,000 probably. Oh, 5,000, even better. Okay. Yeah, we're very happy that we've beaten that boss. But, Ludlit. Begin transposition and give me Lothric's Holy Sword. Okay. So that's that. The only thing we need to do right now is put the cinders back on the throne. And I wonder what that will trigger. That is more than creepy. Now what? Hello? Let's talk to the firekeeper, I suppose. Oh, she walked this way. Hello?
The five lords sit their five thrones. All thanks to thee, most worthy of lords. Ashen One. With the lords as thy witness, bend thy knee afore the bonfire's coiled sword, and let the lord's embers acknowledge thee as their true heir, a true lord, fit to link the fire.
Okay. So is this it then? Is this the end of Dark Souls 3? Well, I guess we're gonna find out in a second. Let's kneel. Ooh, I'm getting goosebumps.
Noble Lords of Cinder.
Oh, wow.
The fire fades.
Ludlit just exploded.
And the lords go without thrones. Surrender your fires to the true air.
Wait, what? Okay. Maybe I should have killed her. Hello, Gertrude. I'm assuming. Are you gonna give that to me, or are you just gonna kill me with that? Because I just started to realize that she's probably Gertrude. The Heavenly Daughter. Fit only for cinders. That's not fire, is it?
Let her grant death.
Oh shit.
To the old gods of Lordran, deliverers of the first flame.
Oh, seriously? Oh shit. Kiln of the First Flame. So we're back at where we ended Dark Souls 1. Oh god. Well, I have a bit of time, so let's light this. It's apparently not over yet. The funny thing was, is this Kiln of the First Flame? Flameless Shrine. So we've been at this Flameless Shrine, if this is the same shrine that we've been to. No? Or is this yet another shrine? Oh god. Okay, this looks different. Holy shit. Another bonfire. Kiln of the First Flame. So it does strike a bit of a resemblance. Most of it is the residue of the explosions, as you can see here and over there, everywhere. Also, something to note, when she touched us, Night Bonfire, she received the five souls. Kiln of the First Flame. She received the five souls, and we only got ashes. Which makes me wonder if we have been screwed over because I let her live. So there's a message over there. So this is the castle, isn't it? This is Lothric Castle, completely destroyed. What's that over there? Because that looks like it's still intact. Oh wait, that is the Kiln of the First Flame, no? Oh god, this is gonna be another boss fight, isn't it? That looks like Gwyn. Hello? Oh shit. Soul of Cinder. Holding that piece, carrying a coiled sword. Holy shit! he can transform it. Wake up! What the hell is he doing? What's he doing? No. Oh shit, yeah, I'm probably dead. Die. shit. Fuck you, you're down, you're down, you're down. No, die, die, you should die. You should die. Oh, that's bullshit. No. What the fuck is this bullshit? What? What? Seriously? Okay. Switch it up. Get out of the way. That was a chance. Oh shit. Circling, 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 circling. Time. Okay, back up. I'm not hitting him. I rolled away. Okay, back up. Easy does it. Easy does it. Easy does it. Easy does it. That's a long one. Okay. Whew. Damn it. Could have done it. Stop stabbing me. Okay. So that's two soul arrows. Don't get too greedy. Let him jump. That's a long one. Running away, 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 running away. Oh shit! Still got hit. Oh shit. Okay, that's a long one. Oh shit. Can I drink? I can drink. Damn it. Fuck! There we go, there we go, there we go. Damn it, I hate it. I hate those. There we go. Jump, jump, jump. Come on, jump. I know I can do it. Nope. Oh, he leaves such an opening when he does that, though. Turning, 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 turning. And then turning around. Come on. No, I can beat this guy. Ah, shit. Okay, that's great. I'm at a sufficient distance, I can spam my soul arrows. Oh yes, going, going, going. No, 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 no. Yeah, there we go, okay. Oh shit, that's a big one. Damn it, I missed it. Ooh, bad drink, bad drink. This hurts! This hurts! This fucking hurts! Damn it! Damn it! I had it! That was scary. Oh. Oh shit. Shit. Fucking hell. Constantly in between these branches. Yes, okay. Late. Damn it. Drinking. That's a long one, I'm stuck. Drinking. There's a hair in my mouth. Come on, do the big one. Or do that. I got him! I didn't even notice. Holy shit! He's down! Fuck you! Fuck you! Soul of the Lords! I think I just completed Dark Souls 3. There's a bonfire over there, so I'm gonna assume that that's the thing I'm gonna have to light to end the game, just as it was in Dark Souls 1. Look at that. Lothric is completely destroyed. Holy shit. Okay, Soul of Lords. I'm gonna read that first before we go into the end. Whew. Since Lord Gwyn, the first Lord of Cinder, many exalted lords have linked the first flame, and it is their very souls that have manifested themselves as defender of the flame. So that's why it was swapping between movesets, since it's a manifestation of every being that linked the fire after Gwyn. Linked the first flame, look at that. We're gonna see what happens, right? Here we go. Yes, I am sure to link the first flame and end this. And this ending should be one of a few. I don't know which one I'm gonna get. Probably the fire one, since I avoided every Dark Lord reference. That looks awesome. With that armor, it looks awesome. And now we're gonna be set aflame, because we just linked the first flame again. We did it. Oh yes, we did it. Is that it? That's a really small first flame if you're comparing it to Dark Souls 1. To link the first flame. Is it over? There we go. Wow. That was amazing. And what a journey it has been. That was a pretty cool last boss fight, by the way. Yeah, it's pretty tough, because you need to go through his first four movesets that he switches between before you get the greatsword and the lightning damage that he switches to. I think that was Gwyn's moveset, right? Well, part of Gwyn's moveset anyway. But really cool boss fight. I tried to stay close to to most of his movesets in the first phase. And when he did his magic, you could stay close and just whack away to kill him in his first phase. The second phase, well, I mostly baited his jump and got a few slashes in every time. And when he was holding his sword up in the air that he was going to do that juggling 5 combo, I backed up and fired a few soul arrows at his face. And that seemed to work eventually, because that took me, well, 2 hours again, but hey, we finished the game. It was a really good Dark Souls, definitely better than Dark Souls 2. I wouldn't call it better than Dark Souls 1, although it's close. I think they're pretty much on the same level for me. It was, of course, pretty cool to see all the references to the previous games, especially the Oiled Royals, Gwyn and his children. And yeah, really great game overall. I really enjoyed it. Hope you guys did as well. I'd like to thank you all for watching. I'm gonna probably let this run out. And well, if there's nothing at the end here, this is a farewell. So thank you guys enormously for watching, especially those of you who watched the entire series. I'm really grateful for that, and I hope to see you in the next and in any of the other series. I have a series about Bloodborne, if you haven't seen it. I have one about The Witcher 3, where we go through that game and its DLC, which is still ongoing, by the way. And I'll probably link these two in the video here. But thanks again enormously for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed it. And if you did, again, don't forget to like this video. But, well, that's it for Dark Souls 3. Thanks again, and goodbye. And maybe I'll see you guys in the DLC. Probably. But goodbye.
And so it all begins anew.
Maybe for those of you still watching, I'm gonna leave this the small resurrect cutscene in. And for those of you still watching, if you'd like me to play it again on New Game Plus, and maybe focus a bit more on the NPC characters and their storyline, let me know in the comments and I might consider it. Aside from that, thanks again for watching, and especially for watching this till the end. And see you guys next time. Goodbye.